Everyone, so welcome back to another episode. I'm Cassie, also known as Crafty Cassie on Instagram and Ravelry, and as well as here on YouTube. I am currently located in my brand new home that my husband and I just bought recently, and it feels really, really good to finally being able to record again. So this is kind of the reason why I've been gone for so long. We bought the house at the, we closed at the end of September, and we moved in shortly after getting the keys, and we're fully moved in by October. By November, I had found out that I needed to go overseas for training exercises. So I was gone for 3 weeks. Over the course of Thanksgiving, and I got home just in time for Christmas. And my husband was also overseas doing work stuff, so he had been gone, and I missed him by a couple of days. It was really sad, but it just happens. So when I finally got home, he had done the entire house ready for Christmas. It was amazing. It was so exciting, and it felt so good to be home. And then, at the same time that we bought the house, we adopted a fur baby. We adopted Sir Kitty. I will insert a photo because probably grabbing him, he's in the window over here looking at the blinds. Grabbing him and holding him so you all could see him probably won't be a good idea. He probably won't tolerate it. He'd probably cry at me. More than likely he would. He's gotten very vocal in the last few months since we've gotten him. He is a neutered male. He's a long hair domestic tabby, as far as we can tell. We adopted him from another family, the next town south of us, and they had actually gotten him from the local animal shelter. So he was neutered, and then we got his shots done and everything, so he's happy, he's healthy, he loves love, and he's just settled in really well here. And then recently, because I also got told that I'm not just going to be going on training, I'm actually going to be gone for the last half of next year actually doing work overseas. So because of that, I decided, after talking with my husband, that he needed something to keep him busy while I'm gone. So what we did is we adopted her. This little ball of fluff, or my little Ewok as we also call her, is Miss Josephine. Yes, Josie. She is a Shih Tzu Pomeranian Chihuahua mix. We have a bell on her because she's so tiny, and then she wears a harness to go out and go potty. We're still potty training. She's 10 weeks old. She's a lover, loves to be held and cuddled. But I'm gonna put her down now so she can go play with the kitty. All right, so it looks like I'm gonna have to download this content real quick and delete some memory off my card, so I will be right back. Alright, so I'm back, and the husband has the dog. If you hear any kind of, like, talking in the background, it is definitely the husband. He's chilling right now. It's Saturday. It's technically our Sunday. We have to go to work tomorrow, so we're just kind of being lazy, and eventually we're going to kick it into gear and get the house ready for the next week. Yeah. Let's go ahead and get started into the podcast itself. I do have show notes for once, so this is going to be a lot more, cohesive, I hope. We'll see. So I'm going to go ahead and start with my finished objects. And the first one I have is a pair of socks. So these are a pair of plain vanilla socks. I'm actually going to pull out something. sorry about the noise, that I knit up for my husband's stepmother. So yeah, it just looks like that. Yeah, aren't those cute? It's just plain vanilla basic with a heel flap. The yarn is actually one of my hand-dyed yarns. Now this is really blown out in the camera. It's showing really pink, more hot pink, and it's more of a red pink rather than so bright like this, but it is very tonal. When this went in the dye pot, it did something weird in the dye pot, and I can't recreate it, so I was going to put it as a one-of-a-kind kind of thing, but I really liked the colorway, so I just nabbed it. So yeah, that's one finished object. So, and then what else did I get done this week? Since the last time we talked, baby hats. I got a lot of, well, not a lot, but I got a few baby hats done. Let's see if I can grab them. Oh, here we go. And three. So I got three baby hats done. This yarn was just in my scraps, so I used that. This one, I'd made a few baby hats already out of it, and then I ran out of yarn, so I added a gray brim. This I want to say is Snuggly Wuggly. I'm not sure. The base is called the Snuggly Wuggly brand, or base. I don't remember the colorway. I know this is Burnett yarn, baby yarn. I don't remember if it's gray or charcoal. I know it's the darker of the two grays that they have in that line. And then this little guy here is the leftover from a baby sweater, which is also one of my finished objects, but I don't have pictures of it. Or I don't have it here to show it to you. I have pictures of it, so I will insert those pictures here. And the yarn is Burnett yarn, and the colorway is baby blue camo, or blue camo. I know it's blue camo. I just don't remember if it was baby boy or baby blue, something to that effect. And then I had also used in the sweater that same yarn in chocolate as well. So that was two finished projects. And then I also finished an adult beanie out of some scrap yarn. So yeah, that's not a whole lot, but it's what I finished since the new year. So I do have a lot of projects on the needles though that I've been working on. So let's go ahead and jump into them. I'm gonna get organized for a little bit. So I will be right back. All right, so let's go ahead and finally get into WIPs, or what this entire podcast is about, my unfinished projects. So I have finally done some work on my Cozy Memories blanket or quilt. I finally finished another square, so that's exciting. I have enough yarn to start a third square, but I'm going to think I'm going to block this off in the Knit Picks stroll in the dough colorway and get the two blocks knit together, so I have a strip for my cozy memories blanket, not just blocks. So that's good. I have since I last showed you, I have added 6 squares. So this one was from a pair of socks that I knit Alex. This is a pair of socks. Nope, not a pair of socks. This was some Debbie Bliss yarn that I knit my husband a hat out of for Christmas. This blue here is some Patton's Croy that I knit one of my coworkers a pair of socks out of. This is some of the Patton's Croy as well that I knit myself socks out of. This is some Premier Yarns and their woolless yarn base, and I knit myself a pair of socks out of this. And then this is my hand-dyed yarn that I knit my husband's stepmother's socks out of. So full block done. So that's exciting. It's still continuing. I'm just going to continue to knit the squares out of my projects that I work on, the leftover bits, and so that will be my, the memories will be based off of those projects. So even if something happens, like they get lost, or I wear holes into the socks, or my husband wears holes in his socks, I still have a memory of the fact that I made those projects. So my coffee for today is in my lovely yarn mug, my procrastin knitting mug. And it says it's a verb, and it is to defer all other activities besides knitting. And then if you look just inside, it has the ball of yarn with knitting needles in it. So it's really cute. I got it at Joann's a few months ago. So I love it. It's one of my go-to mugs right now. So, yes. Another project I have been working on. So you remember how I knit my first baby sweater as a step into the sweater world? Well, it was a serious step, because this is where I now stand on my first knit sweater. So I'm currently working on the sleeves here. I did a couple rows on the body, and so I decided to start on the sleeves now. I don't know if there's decreases just yet, so I haven't really been working on it too diligently lately, because I've had so many other projects on the mind. But this is Tin Can Knits flax sweater pattern. So it's really simple, neck down. There's a little bit of garter in the sleeves, and then it's just knit all over. So it's very simple. I am knitting this in the medium to large size to fit my husband. He doesn't like the color though. So I guess I'm gonna have a really large sweater, which is fine. I don't mind having loose fitting sweaters. I find that that's actually better, because it does one of two things. So in the summer times, I tend to wear sweaters when I'm going to be outside a lot, because, especially the bigger, bulkier ones, because I find that it helps keep me cooler, keeps the sun off my skin, and airflow still, and I don't overheat. Whereas in the wintertime, I love bulky sweaters because I can layer and I can really get warm underneath there. So I am excited that even if he won't wear it, I will. So another project I'm currently working on is this beauty right here, which is in a bit of a halt because I need to charge my Kindle so I can figure out the next row, but it is a crocheted shawl, so it's definitely growing. Go ahead and show you guys the pattern kind of up close. So this bit here this first set of rows here after all of this here is actually worked down, and then you turn and then you work on top of it and build down. So it's actually not a complicated pattern, but you really do have to pay attention to what you're doing and where you're doing it at, or else you're gonna throw off the pattern. I'm using what it calls for, which is the F size hook for the 3.75 meter hook. And the yarn is Western Sky Knits yarn. And this is the MCS Fingerling in their Gumball Sprinkle colorway. No, kitty, you can't get in the craft room. No, sir. So that door right there goes to my craft room, which is a hot mess right now. I'm still organizing it. I've been in this house for months, and there's just so much I have to do in it that it's, I don't go in there a whole lot. Plus it's really cold in there because I have the vent turned off, so that's another reason why I don't go in there. But yeah, oh, there's Kitty. As you can see, he's kind of fluffy. You laughing at me or the dog?
Huh?
You laughing at me or the dog?
The dog, she fell off the couch.
Oh. Okay. So, yeah. The pattern is the dragon fruit pattern, crochet pattern on Ravelry. And the, going back to the crochet pattern before, I just got a little distracted there. This was actually sent to me by the Yarn Over Truck. Based out of California, they asked me to create a sample for them. So they sent me the pattern and the yarn. They sent me an extra, a second skein, because the pattern does call for more than what's in a single skein. So they sent me two skeins. There are 437 yards, and I believe the pattern called for 480. So I'm going to have some leftover. I decided that I wanted to get out some, I wanted a pair of socks for myself. I didn't, up until recently, have any socks on the needles for myself, though I did knit, like, 11 pairs for myself last year. No. Nine? Because I knit 13 in total. So it might have been eight, because I knit one for my mother-in-law, my husband's mother, for a coworker who, no, two coworkers, three, plus three pairs for the husband makes six. I don't want to say I knit myself nine pairs, so I knit 15 pairs of socks last year, holy cow. And right now I am sitting at one pair for the year. Woo! But anyways, this is the leftovers from the socks that I knit my husband's stepmother. So I will actually be pairing that with some Manos de Araguay. Forget the colorway. I believe the colorway means carnival in Spanish. Cat and the dog are playing, so if you hear crinkling and a bell, the crinkling's probably the paper that they are claimed as their play place, and the bell is Josie. So yeah, so I'm gonna do the base side of this, and I'll probably reverse it and do the cuffs, heels, and toe on the other sock with this and the base out of the pink. So they'll be matching but not quite matching, because I don't have enough yarn to do both contrasting heels and toes and the full body sock, so I have to do coordinated like that. So, is that everything that's in here? Huh? Also, have another sock on the needle. Let's see if I can get it out. There we go. This has kind of been in the bag for a while, so it's a little hodgepodgey. So this is the Rippling Tide sock pattern. I got this as a one of the patterns with my Fiberista subscription. And this is 64 count sock, so I'm knitting this on 1.5, so it should fit the husband very well, and that's who it's for. The yarn, I don't have the wrapper for the yarn anymore, sadly. I started losing my wrappers because everything is just, it's been so crazy around here. But anyways, the yarn is one of my first yarns that I got from my Fiberista subscription box. I know that much. And it's very disorganized. So I need to hurry up and finish this sock, actually, so that I can cast on my father-in-law's socks, which I will explain why I am knitting them socks here at the end of the episode, because my husband and I are actually, the husband's actually going to come on the podcast, and we're going to be announcing some news of some sort. Well, I know what it is, but just stay tuned. Okay. So the next project I have been diligently working on, but kind of have put down because of other projects taking precedence, is this guy here. Hey, kitty, you can't have that. Stop. So this is the foolproof infinity scarf, but it is knit like a regular scarf. You knit the center piece here first, and then you knit the length, and then you knit the length, and then you go back, and you knit the two together, because it's knit on the bias, and so on and so forth. So this is a foolproof scarf. The yarns I am using are Juniper Moon yarns. Kitty, no! You want to come say hi? Would you like to come say hi? No? Okay. Then quit playing with my needles, please. The yarns are from Juniper Moons in their Harriet Bays. The colors... I noticed they had a color names this time when I bought them. I want to say this is chocolate, and I forget what the green is called, but it's for my mother-in-law. She loves green, and then she's like, well, what other color would you like? Because we saw it in a store in Port Townsend, which is about 30-minute drive south, and then a ferry across the inlet. And away, so I want to say the ferry ride is about 35 minutes, so it's about an hour ride away from my house, but it's nice to get out of town every once in a while. So we've saw the pattern in one of the local yarn shops there, and my mother-in-law really loved it, so she bought me the pattern, and then I got the yarn later on, and she asked for lime green and brown, so those were the colors that she is getting this made out of. Next one I am super excited about. So if you are participating in the Mina Makes cozy Schlanket mystery knit along, All of the clues have been released. The pattern is at full price now, so I got it before it started, and I had been working on this pretty regularly, and then I had to set it down because I got distracted, which sucks. So anyways, this is where I'm at right now. I'm doing the worsted weight one. I had some issues on the yarn over section, and I just didn't feel like ripping it out, so I left it as is. I'm okay with that. The yarns I'm using are Heartland Tweed is the silver, and this is in the Mount Rainier Tweed colorway. The purple is the Heartland color, or Heartland base, and this is the Isle Royale. And then my third color is going to be this blue, and this is also in the Heartland Tweed, and this is the Glacier Bay Tweed. These are actually deep stash for me. I've had these, let's see here, it'll be a year in April since my husband and I got married. I'd say we moved in together around, like officially around December, October. Let's see here. We met in September. He left in November. So I want to say around November. So it's definitely been over a year that we've been living together. And I bought these probably a year before that. So I've had these 2.5 years now, so I'm glad to be using it, and I really like Mina's patterns, so I'm actually excited to get that worked on. I have another of the blue in here too, and then I have another of the silver. I don't think I'm gonna need another of the purple, and I don't think I'll need the second skeins of the blue and the silver, but I have them from my stash, so I pulled them out just in case. So with that said, I have one last whip to show you guys, and it's one that I have been working on forever. Absolutely forever. Oh! Hey, I found the wrapper! So for that baby hat and the baby sweater and that I knit for my nephew, it is the Baby Bee Sweet Delight Blue Baby Camo. That's it. And then, yes, Kitty. Got a hold of this. Kitty and Puppy both love paper, so they've chewed this one up quite a bit for me. And this was from a pair of socks that I made. Anyways, let's get the shawl out here. Grabs the other skein too. Okay, so here we are. This bad boy is my Waiting for Rain shawl. And I am going on to the fourth or the fifth. 1, 2, 3. I'm going on to the fourth lace panel. I am actually ready. To start that panel. And I think I'm off a row. I think I needed to work the row on this side of the shawl and not this side. So I remember correctly, they go, you know what I mean, on either side, but I'm not sure. I'm just gonna knit it as best as I can. The yarn I'm using is Madeline Tosh in her Merino Singles. Merino Lights. Merino Light. base in the colorways Mare and Ink. I'm using Mare for the garter stitch and Ink for the lace. As you can see there, it's actually looking pretty true to color right now. But I really want to be able to wear this when I go overseas. So I need to get on this at some point. But who knows when that point will be, because it's taking forever. Just get in the bag. Speaking of the bag, look how cute this bag is. It's a cat. My husband got it for me while he was overseas in Japan. So that's exciting. So that is all of my whips in progress. So I'm gonna go ahead and clean up my desk and we'll get into acquisitions. There's a lot. I mean, there's normally a lot, but there is going to be a major Fiberista section because I haven't shown you guys the yarns that I've gotten in my subscription for a few months now. So I've got a few months to show you guys, so that'll be probably the bulk of what I'll be showing you. Plus I got some yarn too. I just hit my tooth. Ow. Alright, I'll be right back. Alright, so let's go ahead and get into acquisitions. This is one of my favorite parts because I love going shopping. In case you haven't noticed already. So, for those of you who have watched my previous episodes, you'll know that I have a spinning wheel. What I didn't have was a way of getting the hand-spun yarn off of my bobbins. But now I do. So I ordered a 1 yard Knitty Knotty. And this is it. It's actually quite small, which is fine. I don't necessarily think I need the 2 yard, but if I do, I can always get it later on. But this is just for practice. I also ordered sock blockers. Oh yeah. So I got the bald knitting needles with my name, Crafty Cassie, etched into them. It took a few months to get it. I guess she'd had some problems with her machine. The woman who made these. I ordered them on Etsy from... from Burning Impressions 2. It's the wooden sock blockers. They're the adult, but they're the extra smalls because I have extra small feet. And these came out of British Columbia, Canada. So just north of where I live. I do happen to live like 2.5-3 hours away from the Canadian border. So, yeah. She also sent a couple of extras to go with it. So I have a lot of crinkling. Put that over there because it's gonna go in garbage later. So she sent me a little lobster clasp how to do the Kitchener stitch. And then she also sent me a ruler. Also on a large lobster clasp, and it's a needle ruler, and then it's got the 1 inch and 2 inch mark. So yeah, that's cool. It has my name on it, Crafty Cassie. So that's that. I also picked up some Patton's yarn in the Croy socks base, and this color is the blue brown marble. And you can kind of see the colors there. I got it. I got two because they're 50 gram skeins. I got them to knit my father-in-law some socks to go with us when we go to Thailand. So this is the other skein from Western Sky Knits that the Yarn Over Truck sent me. So just wanted to show you what it came, what it looked like when it came skeined up. So this is also, this one has more of the red I've noticed. My other skeins seem to be really green. This one also has a lot of green in it too. But I really do love this colorway. It's really very pretty. Let's see if you can start seeing some of that blue in there too. It's really pretty. I really love that blue. So, yeah. I also picked up this season's, yes, the spring edition of the Knit Scene. And this one is just, it really caught my eye. It has some beautiful patterns, like this shawl I really loved. I also, there's a lot of sweaters in here too, like cardigans and stuff like that. I like this sweater vest. Look how cute that is. I love it. I absolutely love it. And then there was the one from the front cover, this sweater, this cardigan actually. I just loved how it was stylized with the, oh, I didn't realize that was a dress. It's a button-down dress with pants, and then they wore the cardigan and a tie. Now, I probably wouldn't wear a button-down dress, but I would definitely wear, like a button-down t-shirt, untucked with a pair of leggings, and then the cardigan. But I really do love that tie. The polka dots on that tie is just, love it. So, yes. I love Knit Scene. I love interweave knits. I love the crochet versions of them too. Those are like the four magazines that I always get just because I've always got such great patterns. And it's all by the same company too, so, but they do such an excellent job on their magazines, and they're just so jam-packed full of legitimate patterns, not just like, oh, go and check out these people because they've got these cool patterns, and I'm just like, okay. And I know advertising is what pays for the magazine, but it's got a lot of legitimate content. Yarns and interviews and patterns and things like that. Stuff that I legitimately want to read. Instead of being inundated with a bunch of advertisements. So I don't know if you recognize these. I'm going to have a little bit of crinkle. As I now can throw away the packaging, so that's awesome. And I ordered from Stranded Dye Works. If you hear more crinkling, it's Kitty. Kitty loves bags. So, he agrees. He decided he didn't want to play. So, anyways, but I ordered from Stranded Dye Works. I don't know if you guys have seen Amy's podcast, The Stranded Podcast, but she's absolutely amazing. She's a little baddie like myself, so I really enjoy watching it. And she also has like little pearls of wisdom. I don't think she realizes they're pearls of wisdom, but I take them as pearls of wisdom because, like, she was the one who told me not to put my knitting on a pedestal. Don't put projects on a pedestal. Just jump in and do them. Don't be afraid. Like, I was super afraid of trying knitting sweaters because I was like, I don't want to waste the yarn. Like, so much money wasted, and if it doesn't come out perfectly, like, I won't be happy. And I'm finding that that's not necessarily the case. Like the sweater, I already see a ton of mistakes in it, but I'm loving knitting on it, and I'm loving learning experience, and so I can't not knit it. So thank you, Amy, for your little pearls of wisdom. And for my order that I got from her, this, they are on her solo, her singles base. This is a flamingo legs. It is a corally base with black speckles. I think she said it was navy. Might be navy, but they're coming out very black. But I love it. I fell in love with this when I first saw it, when she first started dyeing this. I was like, I need to get me a skein of that. I really wanted to get it in the Oasis base, which is her merino nylon base that's meant for socks. But it was sold out. Actually, I think she had this in the Oasis, but she didn't have this in Oasis. So what I did is I got them in her solo base. I actually have a few singles bases, so I think I'm just going to continue to get a few more, and I might try and do the Find Your Fade shawl. I know these are kind of far away from each other in the color spectrum, but I couldn't. This is anti-Valentine. This is her new Valentine's Day colorway. I couldn't pass it up. I had to get it when I saw that she had put up some, so I got it. And it is so beautiful, so variegated. It is, I want to say it's a pink and black base. It's very, very beautiful. And she tied a little note to it and said, "Hi, Cassie, thank you so much for your order, Amy, with love." She put a little X on it. If I remember correctly, an X is a kiss. But yes, it's already got cat hair on it.
Kitty.
He loves yarn. He absolutely loves yarn. He's not allowed in the craft room because there's so much yarn. And he does naughty things to the yarn, so he doesn't get allowed in the yarn room. In what my husband has dubbed paradise for Kitty. So, yeah. Yarn beards. Anyways, but yes. It's 100% superwash merino. It's a single ply fingering weight. It is anti-Valentine. Wait, does this say what it is too? It does. It does have the name on it. Colorways forming the legs, okay. And there are 366 meters or 400 yards. So.
Yes. Yes, my friend.
So. That is the yarns I've gotten that weren't part of my Fiberista subscription. So, there is a bag here that is not at my fingertips. I'm just gonna save it for another time. I may just put it all away and say, whatever. But I'm gonna go ahead and get into the Fiberista because I'm pretty sure this episode is really long right now, even with all the editing I'm gonna be doing, so, because I still have blather at the end for you guys. So I'm just gonna hop into Fiberista. So, the first month I'll be showing you is wrapped in silver tissue paper. Ha, ha, ha. is a retrospective. Oh my goodness. Oftentimes during the time of the year, this time of the year, we spend a lot of time both looking into the past to see how far we've come and looking excitedly into the future to envision where we'd like to be. As Fiberista Club celebrates its 2-year anniversary, we're both grateful for how far our members have allowed us to come and excited for our 3rd year of club shipments. We've decided to begin this year with a retrospective on some of our favorite featured yarns, albeit with a twist. Just like Fiberista Club, dyers and yarn companies evolve, offering new bases and colors, and we're going to take a moment to celebrate some of their very best offerings. This month's sock yarn features a glorious blend of superwash merino, cashmere, and nylon from Ba Yarns, our very favorite dyers when it comes to machine washable bases in glorious color palettes. To start 2017 in the sweetest way possible, we're also indulging a treat from a local bakery you can indulge in while working on your next project. This month's patterns will be released. I already have them and downloaded them. So this is this month's colorway from Ba Yarns in the Savannah base. And this colorway is called S'mores. And I am absolutely in love with this yarn. When I saw it, I was like, oh, yes. Oh, I was so, I love Ba Yarns, and I think this is my 3rd or 4th, maybe even 5th skein I have of hers. I have them in all different colorways, and I love it. This, it still feels more like merino than the cashmere, but it's definitely soft. So that's exciting to get that. And then my bakery is from Silverland Bakery in the Chocolate Chunk. And then it's got the ingredients in the back. Manufactured on a shared equipment and in a plant with wheat, flour, dairy, eggs, peanuts, tree nuts, and soy. So if you've got those kinds of allergies, this may not be a treat for you. But I'm excited about it. I wrapped this one up very well, back up very well, or I haven't, I've opened this one. I haven't seen this one because I also fell in love with this one too. Yep, I have. It smells like vinegar. Ugh. I wish people would wash their yarn enough to where it got rid of the vinegar smell, but they can't help it, I guess. When they could, they can't. Alright, so this is the October colorway. It says, Feeling Witty. We don't know about you, but we're most creative at night, during the winter time, as daylight savings time ends and the sun begins to set a little sooner. We exercise our creative muscles in various ways, but of course, fiber arts tend to win the majority of our attention. With the extra surges of creativity and the hunkering down in the longer evenings of the year, we want to get your mind and hands moving, and that's what this month's shipment is all about. We're featuring the yarns and fiber of Knitted Wit in an incredible range of colors. For our sock club shipment, members will be receiving their very wonderful Victory sock base in a range of colors. This glorious blend of 80% superwash merino and 20% nylon is brilliantly plied. And I want to say that this is a high twist yarn. It looks like it. Our swag this month is an extension of our desire to inspire your creativity. Joey has hand-drawn 4 custom illustrations for club members, and we've had them printed on greeting cards for you. Make the card yours by coloring it in and writing a handwriting note inside as an accompaniment to your next handmade gift. This month's patterns will be released. I already have them and downloaded. So, I got 2 of the cards. I've got the alpaca one. How cute. And I've got the rabbit one. Also, how cute. And the colorway I got is the Rock Candy Black. And there are 420 yards. It's absolutely beautiful. It's got black and gray and blues, some browns, some green. I'm really excited for this, to make these into socks. And the last bag I was able to find, this may be November, this may be December, I don't know which one, but eventually I will find the other one and I'll show it to you guys. Actually, I think I showed you guys November's. There might have been a typo with the release date, because I've got October Eleganza. So I think I just showed you guys, I think this was November's. And this one is October's. So, if you ask me, October is the very best month of the year. It's enchanting. Maybe it's because you can feel the seasonal change, or because you can finally wrap yourself in a shawl or a cardigan without getting awkward stares from people. I'll break out sweaters in late August because fall is coming. It's so much nicer to enjoy your woolly goodies when they're providing both function and fashion. Yes, that's it. Kitty's enjoying some crinkly time on the paper and plastic, so... He saw me looking at him, so he's going to go look at the window. You're going to want to wind up this month's yarn right away and start working with it ASAP. Chalamere Yarns is our club feature for the month, and we're showcasing their Breathless yarn for our sock club, featuring cashmere, silk, and superwash merino. Bouncy. Our chosen palette is perfectly... What are you doing, baby? You want to come say hi? Oh, you're so heavy. This is your kitty. He's under a year old and he weighs like 10 pounds. Look how fluffy he is. He's so fluffy. Yeah, yes you are. You're just so fluffy. You want down? Mm-hmm. Yeah? Okay, here you go. We've chosen palette. Our chosen palette is perfectly on trend for this year's fall and winter season, including some steel blues and grays, bold colors, and a wonderful dusty pink. Look in your package for a button you can use to show off your status as a fiberista. I like to use them to mark the right side of my work and place them on my project bag so I can use them as needle stoppers. Place the pin at the base of your circular needles with the work hanging on your cord. Knitting hack for the win. Okay. This month's patterns will be released. I already have them. So. Yes. Alright. So, here's the free gift. The pattern. The button. It's just the Fiberista Club logo.
You silly kitty.
So, this is it, Chalamere Yarns. Beautiful logo. Love that horse. And this one is called Curtain Call. In their Breathless colorway, and it is 420 yards. This is 15% cashmere, whereas this one... Is there cashmere in it? No. This one's cashmere. So this one's definitely softer than this one. But not by much. So, it's beautiful. But just a heads up, this is my second maroon colorway. I want to say the color I can't find. The month that I can't find is my December colorway, and I believe that was a maroon as well. I believe that was a um, Oh, it's another big company, Bandai company, that a lot of people use. It's not Madeline Tosh. Malabrigo. I believe it was a Malabrigo in their singles colorway, in their singles base, and it was also a maroon color. But yeah. Again, this is 420 yards. But it is really beautiful. I can see why they call this curtain call. If you've ever been to like a live play or been in a play, most of the curtains that I've ever seen have always been kind of like a red velvet or some sort of red heavy material. My high school had blue, but I believe it was because our main color was royal blue, so we were the Bulldogs, and our colorways were gray, red, blue. What did the freshmen wear? Might have been white. Might have been, but don't quote me on that. I do remember us being very patriotic, though, in our colorways. But yeah, so. But a lot of the other theaters that I've either been to or have done plays at had red curtains. So I can see why they called this curtain call. It's beautiful. I have so much sock yarn and so many projects I want to knit. Like, yes. I will never have enough yarn. I don't think anybody ever will. But yeah. So I'm gonna go ahead and put all of this away, and then I will be right back with the husband and we'll do some blather. So